Sairam children, so again we will start our maths class with chapter 3 addition. We will continue. Okay, now tell me, so far what we have done in addition, what we have completed? Yes, we have finished in the chapter addition, the addition facts, two digit addition, then three digit addition, expanded numbers, carry over addition, skip counting, and today we will be doing word problems. What we will do today? Word problems. Okay, so get ready with your book, notebook, pencil, eraser, everything. Are you ready? Okay, see children, so far we have done the addition like this. Numbers are given to you and we will add the numbers. Okay, so what is the number? 302 plus 241. So we have to add these two numbers. So let's begin from the place of ones. We will add the number 2 plus 1. How much you are getting? 3. Then come to the tens place. 4. We got 4. And 3 plus 2, 5. So the total is 543. Or by adding these two numbers, how much did you get? Altogether, we got 543. But today I will teach you word problems. How we have to do the word problems. Now, what is word problems? In word problems, the sum or the problem is written in one or two sentences or in few sentences, and from that we have to follow few steps, write the numbers, understand the question, and then we have to solve the problems. Okay, so I will teach you how. You will read carefully the question, then one by one or step by step you will write the numbers and add the numbers, and you will get the answer. Okay, now look here. See, there are 17 girls and 21 boys in your class. Okay, 17 girls and 21 boys in your class. How many students are there in your class altogether? Altogether means, what is the meaning of altogether? You have to add both the girls and boys and you will get the total how many students are in your class. So how we will write? See, first you will read the question, you will try to understand. Now see, number of girls, tell how many number of girls? 17. So 7 in ones place and 1 in tens place. Okay, like this you will write. Then number of boys, how many? 21. 21. So 1 and 2, plus sign is given here. Now you have to add these two numbers. You have to add the number of girls and number of boys to get the total number of students in your class. Okay, now start adding. We will add 17 plus 21. Start from the ones place, add the numbers. 7 plus 1. How much? 8. And 1 plus 2? 3. So the answer is, there are, here you will write, 38 students in class. Okay, have you understood how to do the word problems? Okay, now look here. We will do this sum. First, we will read the sum and do it together. Chinky has 284 beads. How many beads Chinky is having? 284. Kritika has 326 beads. How many beads are there in all? So together, all together, how many beads are there? So we have to add the beads. So first, what we will write? Chinky's beads. You can see here. So 284. So write 482. Now you have to write Kritika's beads. That is 326. 3, 2. Okay, 326. So that is 6 in ones place, 2 in tens place, and 3 in hundreds place. Now, to get the total number of beads, to get how many beads are there, we have to add the number of beads. So, shall we start adding? Add the numbers. 4 plus 6. How much did you get? How much? 4 plus 6? 10. So what we will write there? What you have to write? We will write, for 10 we will write 0. And 1 will be carried over to the tens place. Keep the 1 above 8. And then we have to add these 3 numbers in the tens place. That is 1 plus 8, 9. And 9 plus 2, 11. You do your rough work. Okay. And then again, that 1 will be carried over here to the hundreds place. And we will add all these 3 numbers. 1 plus 2, 3. And 3 plus 3. 6. So the answer, there are how many beads? How many beads are there? Tell me. There are 610 beads. Understood? 610. Do it. Finished? Okay. Note it down in your notebook. Very good. Now let's see the next one. What is the question? Read together with me and listen also. There were 146 passengers in a train. Passengers, the number of people sitting in a train. Okay, they are in a train. Now, 93 more passengers got in at the next station. So, when the train stopped in the next station, how many people get in? How many people? Yes, 93 passengers got inside. Now, it is asking, how many passengers are there in the train now? So, what you have to do? Yes, what you will write? Passengers, 146, so write 6, then 4, then 1, okay. Now new passengers are 93, 3 and 9, okay. Now, after that, we will start adding to get the total number of passengers. So, you write it down. 146 and 93. Now we will add these two numbers. Now after adding 6 plus 3, how much you are getting? We are getting 9. Then 4 plus 9, count 4 plus 9 is 13. And 13 is a two-digit number. What will happen to the 1? It will be carried over here and we will add 1 plus 1, that is 2. So how many passengers are there in now? There are 239 passengers in the train. Okay? Finished? Okay. Now look here. See the question. The total marks scored by Nancy are 43 more than Amish. Okay. So Nancy is a girl. How much marks she scored? She scored 43 more marks than Amish. Okay. Now let's see what it is written. If Amish total marks are 367, how many marks has Nancy scored? So what we have to do? First we have to see how many marks Amish is getting. So Amish marks is 367. So write 7, 6 and 3. And Nancy's extra marks is 43 more. Whatever marks Amish is getting, 43 more she got. Okay, 43. So 3 and 4. So what we have to do now to get Nancy's marks? We have to add 367 plus 43. Now 7 plus 3, first add these two numbers in the ones place. 7 plus 3 is 10. Okay. Now 1 will be carried over here. 1 plus 6, 7. Then 7 plus 4. How much it is? 11. And again 1 will be carried over here. We will add the numbers 1 plus 3 in the hundreds place and we are getting 4. So Nancy's marks are, how much she scored? Her marks is 410. Okay, finish it. It is in our book only. Finish the sum. So have you understood what is word problems? The sum is given in a way or written in few sentence, and from that you have to read carefully and write what it is asking. You will write like this step by step and you will get the total number. Okay. Yes, now see the question, children. Ashima has a collection of 87 stamps. Rohit has 86 stamps. And Shanu has 75 stamps. How many stamps do they have in all? Okay, they all three are having stamps. The number is given. Now you have to write. Now stamps with Ashima, 87, 7, 8, okay, 87, so 7 in 1's place and 8 in 10's place. Now stamps with Rohit, 86, okay, 86, and Shanu is having 75 stamps. Stamps with Shanu, 5 and 7, like this, 75. Now, to get the total number of stamps, we have to add all these three number of stamps. They are having the number of stamps, so we will add together and we will get the total number of stamps. So shall we start? Add the three numbers in the ones place. 7 plus 6, how much it is? 13. And 13 plus 5, 13 plus 5 is 18. Okay, so we will write 8 and carry over 1 to the tens place. Then 1 plus 8, 1 plus 8, how much you are getting? 9. Okay, then what we have to do? Which numbers we will add? 9 plus 8. Now start counting 9 plus 8. 9 plus 8. How much did you get? 17. Okay, 17. So do the rough work. Try to remember 17 you got. So 17 plus this 7. Okay. Now see how much we are getting. 7 plus 7, 14. Carry over 1 here. 1 plus 1, 2. So we are getting 24. So how we will write here? Write 4 here and 2 here. So the total number of stamps, 248. Okay. Now write the answer here. Ashima. So the answer is Ashima, Rohit and Shanu together have 248 stamps. Correct? Write it down. And children, please do the rough work. Now this is your homework. A school has 638 students. So students, you will write 638. 216 new admissions join the school. So how many new children, new student came? 216. So how many students are there in school now? So get the total number of students. You have to add these two numbers and you will get the answer. You will get the total number of students. So boxes are made. Steps are given. You will read the question. Write it down in proper place. Add it and write the answer. Now there are whatever answer you are getting students in the school. Okay. Now the next one. Fishing boat A caught 173 fish. Fishing boat B caught 87 fish. Fishing boat C caught 214 fish. How many fish did the three boats catch in all? So boat A, boat B, boat C. Write down the numbers. Then add, you will get the total. Then you will get the number of fish was caught. The three boats together caught dash fish. You will write the answer. Now this question. In a fair there were 228 men, 214 women and 315 children. How many people were there in the fair? Okay, it is similar only, the sums we have done. So you write the number of men, number of women and number of children and then add these three numbers to get the total number of people they were in the fair. And write the answer, there were dash people in the fair. Okay, have you understood children, what is word problem? So read the question carefully. write down the numbers in their place, what it is asking, and then do the addition to get the total number or how many there are or whatever altogether it is asking. Okay, with the word problems. So with this word problems, we will be finishing our addition chapter. Okay, and practice the sums very nicely. Okay, now see what we will doing. We will be revising the tables of 1 and 2. Do you remember? We have done in first standard. Shall we read together? Okay. The tables of 1 first we will do. 1 ones are 1. 1 twos are 2. 1 threes are 3. 1 fours are 4. Yes, go on repeating. 1 fives are 5. 1 six are 6. 1 sevens are 7. 1 eights are 8. 1 nines are 9. 1 tens are 10. Remembered? Yes. Now read the tables of 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 2 six are 12, 2 sevens are 14, 2 eights are 16, 2 nines are 18, 2 tens are 20. In your notebook you can write these tables also. Okay, we have done the revision of the tables also. Write it down in your notebook. Okay, now we will do the tables of 3. So table of 1 completed, 2, and now 3 we will do the division. Now read with me. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, 3 six are 18, 3 sevens are 21, 3 eights are 24, 3 nines are 27, 3 tens are 30. Okay, so we revise the tables of 1, 2 and 3. So write the tables also in your notebook for your revision work. Now come to the maths activity. Tick the correct option. Carefully read the question. See, there are 20 birds in a tree. So 20 birds were sitting on a tree. And then 40 more joined them. How many birds are there in all? So 20 were there and 40 more came. So you have to add the numbers. 20 plus 40, we are getting 60. Rima has 100 beads. Nisha has 30 beads. How many beads are there in all? 100 plus 30, 130. You can do the rough work, okay? 130. Now see, Rahul has 60 pencils. His mother gave 30 pencils to him. How many pencils do he have in all?
He was having 60 pencils. Now his mother gave him 30 more pencils. So what is the total number of pencils he is having? 60 plus 30. How much? The correct answer is 90. Now the fourth question. A fruit seller sold 44 oranges in the morning. Okay. And 36 oranges in the evening. How many oranges did he sell in the whole day? So in morning also he sold the oranges, that was 44, and in evening it was 36. So add the number of oranges to get the total. 44 plus 36, how much we are getting? 80. So the correct answer is 80. Virat scored 157 and 188 runs in two school cricket matches. Okay, there was a cricket match in his school. In first match, how much did he score? 157. And then in the next match, he scored 188. So what was his total score? We have to add these two numbers to get Virat's total score. So rough work you do, add these two numbers and we will get the correct answer is 345. Okay, so finish your word problems, all the sums solve in your book, in your notebook. And understood the maths activity, how you will do? You do the rough work and then tick the correct option. Okay? Thank you, children. Bye.